Now setting the target sitemap. So now we have the traffic flowing between the browser but an OS BWA virtual machine. So we can beginning with the scope of first. So for this we have to open our website which is deploy in our VM. So just I'm opening the web browser. I'm using a embedded web browser. Okay, so just I have opened the browser and you can see that this is the Google request. So just right now turn off the intercept on, now turn on and you can see the target. Okay, so here is just I'm doing hold one. Okay. Just I will remove after the accessing the website. So for example, HTTP IP address 192.168 33.131. Just accessing the website. And you can see that the request here, not this one. Okay. And you are here, you can find that the IP address of that which VM of OS BWA. I'm just removing other one because we have to practice on this. Okay, so this is the all about the setting us sitemap. So now here we can see that the multiple path of for particularly which scope we have to add. For example, we have to add this particular in a scope. So for example, right click and add a scope. Yes. In scope, you will identify the particular which we have added the scope, or you can manually add the link here and you can paste the URL here. Now let's understand regarding the message editing. So on almost every tool and tab with Burpshoot that display HTTP message, so you will see the editor identifying the request and response. So this is commonly referred to as a message editor. So message editor allows the viewing and editing HTTP request and response with facility. For example, within a request, you can find the row header hex, the setup of the this is a row header hex HTML sometime and sometime it's a render. You can find the render here. We will see in any other request, but you can find that. And you can check the parameter in, for example, target sitemap. Okay, sitemap, and here is the request. Okay, so you can find the row header X. And response, you can find the row render. So it's all about the, for example, you can find the page of a render here. So it's all about the message editing. So if you are forwarding the request, then you can modify request and you can check the response as of that modified request. So this is all about the message editor in a workshop. Now let's talk about the repeater. So repeater allow for slight changes or any modify request, so it displayed in the left window. So for example, if we have to change any parameter, for example, this is the request proxy HTTP history. For example, this is the request. So we can send it to repeater, and you can find that request in a year. After that, you can send the request. So you can identify the request here, and you can find the render here. So repeater tab is useful for if you have to change any particular parameter or any modification in request. So you can check the what is the response after modifying the request. So repeaters allows you to manually modify and then reissue an individual HTTP request. Analyze the response that you receive. So we will use a repeater quite a bit in this video. This video just an introduction to repeater and to understand the purpose. Now let's talk about the decoding with the decoder in Burp. So Burp decoder is a tool that allow a tester to convert a raw data into encode the data, or take a encode data and convert it to back the plain text. So decoder support the several format including URL encoding, HTML encoding, base encoding, and binary decode, hash data, and other. So decoder also include a built-in hex editor. So for example, we have a website here. So just checking the HTTP history. Any, for example, this. Okay. So just we are sending this request to decoder. Send to decoder. Just need. Just select that and send to decoder here. So we have to select the specific. We have to find the HTTP request you generated from your browser within a proxy HTTP history, and you can find out the value of PHP session ID, and just click on that and send it to decoder. Okay. Just and you can check with the find, you will find that particular value here, and you can decode as a which you want to, for example, URL, for example, plain. Which format you have to encode or decode, you will identify the from here. Okay, so this is all about the decoder. In this example, we cannot proceed any further. We can confirm the value was. So for example, you can base 64. So you can check with the particular base 64, the purpose of receive. So you can use a decoder to manipulate the encoded value in short. So this is the very useful tool for decode any HTML coding, a base 64 encoding, binary code, hash data, or including URL. Most important, intruding with the intruder. So the burp intruder allow a tester to brute force or first specific portion of HTTP message using a customized payload. So you can set up the customized attack using an intruder. and tester will need to use the setting available for the sub types of intruder. So for example, intruder, you can here find that, and you can find the attack target. So for example, we will check any admin history. If we have login, maybe not login, just checking with the admin. Okay, so we logged in as admin. Now we will check the history of HTTP request. We will check the any admin request. Yeah, this is the admin request. So we can send that request to, for example, into intruder target or specific host, port number, and the position. So first we clear all and we can add the password. For example, if we have to forge the password, so just click on add that. Now set up payload. For example, right now I have set a for example, right password. For example, just checking with the wrong password, and we can use the intruder to log in it. So just I'm log out. Okay, just I'm logging with the wrong password. Okay. Okay, so it's incorrect password, but we will check that request in a here. Okay, this is the wrong password that I have entered. So just I am sending this request to intruder to fuzz our password. So just after clear all, for example, and for example we have add and just add the payload. For example, password admin. You can use any, for example, if you have to use a numbers, date, brute force, null payloads, you can use from here. But right now we are using it just simple to understand that. And after that option, send the connection close. Okay. Request attack result graph match. For example, you can add the graph match. For example, error, exception, illegal, invalid to remove that. Or you can add the redirection, but just we are starter attack. Okay, here you can find that the, for example, it's status code 200, but it's a different. So you can find that the 302. Okay, and admin and response we will check, which are not found. Just checking the header or this render. Okay, so we are logging as a admin. You can find that the admin, we are able to log in using this password. So you can modify any request, or you can brute force using your payloads. For example, here is a payload set, simple list, runtime file, custom character, case modification, recursive grep, based on your requirement. So in using a intruder, burp intruder allow a tester to brute force or fuzz a specific portion of HTTP message. So using a customized payload. So to we have seen this one of the example. We have brute forced the password.